If Neverland is everything it's cracked up to be, then a precious should be able to arrive there with enough fairy dust, as long as it's okay for them to remain forever young. Daddy pirated their playpen like a treasure chest and made you second guess the motherfucking Etch-A-Sketch. As far as Precious felt, if being childlike was criminal, then you could lock them up and throw away every residual. Growing up was hard. After everything, the larger part of Precious really loved the playground swing. The Toys R Us kid attitude was very real, but Jeffrey as a giraffe wasn't quite a human shield, and Precious felt as lost as a child in a mall. And all the pain was hardly worth a pile of their toys. They might as well have gotten pried right out an oyster shell, or drawn right out the ground just like a fucking oil well. And Daddy liked the hanky-panky more than carrot cake, which made the Precious struggle just to find a happy place. If Laser Viper could have seen a fucking lake of fire, then it clearly was suggested not to tempt an ankle biter. They didn't want to grow up, and they liked being a kid, even if, as Peter Pan, they fought the giant squid. For every Captain Hook who tried to push them off the grid, there was a special place where every happy thought was hid. They didn't want to grow up, and they liked being a kid, even if, as Peter Pan, they fought the giant squid. For every Captain Hook who tried to push them off the grid, there was a special place where every happy thought was hid. Every zany Monday left the Precious feeling shipwrecked. You could have shared the news if you devised a printing press. As far as Precious felt, if being little was a crime, then you could throw away the key and join a fucking concubine. Growing up was hard, considering it all. The larger part of Precious really clung to Legoland, and feeling small was something with a great deal of perks, almost like a steak meal with mashed potatoes served. There was a lot of good that came from being like a gnome, for instance calling onesies on the fucking Flintstones phone. The darkness liked to creep in like a fucking overcast, and tried to hang around like swinging vines and silverbacks. The child that they strove to be was feeling hopelessness, but tried to make up for it with a little showmanship. If Laser Viper could have seen a schoolboy raise a lighter, or a schoolgirl save a whaler, then we all could change a diaper. They didn't want to grow up, and they liked being a kid, even if, as Peter Pan, they fought the giant squid. For every Captain Hook who tried to push them off the grid, there was a special place where every happy thought was hid. They didn't want to grow up, and they liked being a kid, even if, as Peter Pan, they fought the giant squid. For every Captain Hook who tried to push them off the grid, there was a special place where every happy thought was hid. If Peter Pan could call a pizza van for Little Precious, then hopefully a personal cheese pizza would relax them. If Little Precious could be somewhat more like Peter Pan, then hopefully a Lost Boy could befriend Lieutenant Dan. If every Lost Boy hung out with their army correspondent, then hopefully, as Forrest Gump, we all feel more in common. If Forrest Gump believes that life is like a box of chocolates, then hopefully we all can keep a cherry where we want it. They didn't want to grow up, and they liked being a kid, even if, as Peter Pan, they fought the giant squid. For every Captain Hook who tried to push them off the grid, there was a special place where every happy thought was hid. They didn't want to grow up, and they liked being a kid, even if, as Peter Pan, they fought the giant squid. For every Captain Hook who tried to push them off the grid, there was a special place where every happy thought was hid.